Hi everyone. Till now we have learned two middlewares. One is email and the other is DevTools. In this video, we will learn another very important middleware, Persist, which can persist states for us. Let's take a look at our website. I add bear, add bear, add cats, everything looks fine. But if I refresh the page, then the bears become zero and also the big cats become zero. That means no states were persisted. This is not ideal because sometimes we want to keep the states. How can we do that in Zustand library? Let's go back to our code. At first, take a look at our bear store. So here I have the DevTools. For simplicity, I just remove the DevTools so that we get a clear code. Okay, code is cleaned. In traditional way, you maybe will use the local storage or session storage, get or set the data every time you change the states. So there will be a lot of work to do. But luckily in Zustand library, there is an official middleware called Persist, which can do all the work for you. So you don't need to write so many codes. Let's take a look how can we do that. So, since it's a middleware, so everything the same as the other middlewares, just wrap the state creator inside the create function and use the smart selection, control shift, right, and add a parenthesis. Here you give the persist from Zustand middleware. And here we get some complaint from TypeScript, because we need here a second argument, which is an option. And in the options argument, there is a property called name. Here we give it a bear store. So you need to give a unique name. Okay, now let's go to our website, refresh, and add bear, refresh. This time we see our data is persisted. So let's right-click Inspect and go to Application and see the local storage and here our web URL. See here the key bear store and here the value is our state. Okay, cool. But here we see the Zustand library saved the states in local storage as default. But sometimes we want to save the state in other place. For example, the session storage, async or index.db. This can also simply be done in our option argument. So in the second argument, the option argument, then there is a property called storage. And here you can give a create JSON storage, which is also from the Zustand middleware. And here inside it, you can give the callback function, which returns the storage you want to save. For example, local storage, this is default. And in some case, you want session storage. So here we just try with the session storage. And here, let's click the session storage and the states appears here. Okay, let's delete it. Clear. And we still use the default local storage. Okay. Now, let's talk about the partialize option. This means we can save only a part of the states. Let's say we have another two states. For example, color, it's a string, and the size, it's also a string. And here, color, we give it red. Size, we give it big. So, let's go to our website. And we see here, as default, it will save all the states for us. Go back. Let's go to the option. There is a partialize option. And here, we can give the states we want to save. For example, here state, and which we can return the states we want to save. Bears, state.bears. Here, you see, now we have only bears. Sometimes you have a lot of states, and you just want to exclude one or two states. How can we do that? The simplest way is just to go to our documentation. Here, in the persisting store data, you will see the author have given you this code. The code is simply filter the state entries which include the given keys. Okay, let's copy the code here. Paste it here and change the full to size. Okay, let's go to our website. See, size is excluded. And we can also add another state, color. Save and take a look here. You see, now we have only bears. Okay, another thing I want to mention is clear storage. Sometimes you just want to clear your storage. This can also be simply done. Just go to our bear box. I add a button, clear storage, and here, unclick. Here we can directly use the function, use bear store dot persist dot clear storage. Okay, let's take a look. See here, clear storage. Click, then we see here states are disappeared. But when I add bear, it's still the number is here because we only clear the storage, but we didn't clear the memory. So the clear storage is simply clear your storage. This often happens if some data go broken, then you use this function. So keep in mind, this is important. If you really need to reset your states, I would suggest to you to write a reset state function. So it's very simple. I just make an example. Give it a reset function type in the bear store type here. And here, we can just write the reset function, and it's simply put all the initial state here. That's all. Okay, now let's add the persist middleware to our cat store. Click our cat store. Here we see a small problem. Here is email, here is the dev tools. Where should we put the persist middleware? So, actually, after I test, I think it should be put in the first position. That is before the dev tools. Use our smart selection, control shift, right, and add the parentheses. Then persist, import it from our Zustand middleware. And don't forget here. So we see that's here. We should put a option, just a name, give the name cat store. Okay, let's go to our website. See, here cat store is already appeared. And add a bigger cat, refresh. Add a small cat, refresh. Correct. So this is all about the Persist middleware. And if you want to know more about the Persist, then you can just go to the documentation. And here is see the full documentation for the middleware. Click here. And you will see more options. Okay, this is all about the Persist middleware. In the next video, we will talk about how to subscribe the global states and also the subscribe with selector middleware.